windows. I couldn't tell if there were authorized ballot watchers inside or not. That point was never mentioned. Look, just because they covered the windows and prevented the public from watching doesn't prove there was fraud. But there are more claims of voter fraud to look at, like statistical abnormalities. I'm sure by now you've seen these graphs, showing a sudden surge in Biden votes in the swing states of Michigan and Wisconsin. Basically, Trump was in the lead. Then, officials in these states made the unprecedented decision to shut down for the night. Then, around 4 a.m. on the morning of November 4th, a sudden influx of Biden votes came in. In Michigan, Biden received almost 138,000 votes overnight, while Trump got none. Obviously, it's nearly impossible for that to be legit. And it wasn't. Within 40 minutes of that posting, Decision Desk HQ posted this update saying that was a clerical error. They posted an update that took away about 110,000 votes from Biden and added about 16,000 to Trump. Okay, that looks a little more reasonable. But then, shortly after, they posted another update that added almost 160,000 votes to Biden and only 30,000 to Trump. In other words, those new votes split roughly 85% in Biden's favor. That's unusually high. To explain that, you'd need to assume those votes came from a deep blue county and only included mail-in ballots, which generally skew towards Biden. However, going by data at the time, let's take a look at the deep blue county of Washtenaw. It went for Biden by the largest margin. But even there, the votes were split by less than 82% for Biden. And the votes from there were only about 126,000 total. So the tens of thousands of Biden votes must have come from somewhere else, not Washtenaw County. Now you might say that, well, Republicans discourage voters from casting mail-in ballots. So it makes sense that more mail-in ballots were for Democrats. But what's strange is, when it comes to mail-in ballots, more of them were requested and returned by Republicans than Democrats in early voting here. There's more. There were also other statistical anomalies in the votes. Statistical abnormalities are also not proof of voter fraud. But when vote tallies don't seem to match with previous data or show weird anomalies, it might be worth investigating. Now let's look.